Really just to, break the ice, what is a DAO for someone that's never heard of it before?
Yeah, so I think that word hinders DAOs a lot, right? Because it's such a huge spectrum. But basically, a DAO is really any group of people that are governing a system transparently and using blockchains to do so.
Awesome. So, have there never been DAOs before blockchain? Do you think blockchain was the missing technology that, we needed to allow DAOs to be what they are today?
I think it was. I think we've had groups like that for long before blockchain. But yeah, blockchain seems to be what has really unlocked their potential.
And is it just, this decentralized database that, is a public ledger that, you can actually look into every action that the DAO's taking and every ADA that the DAO spent or received, is that really what, allows, DAOs to come to fruition in our society today?
Exactly. That's my feeling, is that the transparency is the biggest thing, right? We have this trusted, transparent ledger, as you said. So yeah, everything the DAO or the group does is not only verifiable before so on Cardano, but transparent.
So why are DAOs important? For the average person, or maybe even not for the average person, let's say, a group of people, whether it be, something similar to a company, why are they
Right.
important?
Right. So even and that's why I said that word could hinder DAOs a little bit, because even companies, right, or small groups of individuals, what this technology does is it removes not only the need to trust people that they're going to be honest, but they're not going to make human error, which are so common. So it removes human error from a lot of situations, and it removes trust.
Do you have any historical knowledge of, say DAOs before blockchain? Is this something that's new, or is this really just an evolution of previously existing systems?
Yeah, I would say it's an evolution, right? I would say that a lot of my academic friends, academics in ADA, would say that there's plenty of research you could point to that would suggest DAOs aren't a new thing. And I would agree with that, but I think we haven't seen DAOs like this, right? Until blockchain, until smart contracts, and now I would say until smart contracts on Cardano.
Awesome. So what is a DAO?
Yeah,
And
so,
it's and also what is its core mission?
right. So ADAO is pretty cool. ADAO is a DAO on Cardano. Last year, after the Alonzo fork, when Plutus was available, it was really a group of people, some like myself, who were researching DAOs on other chains, participating in them. And what we were doing was trying to figure out how to build them on Cardano. And natively, a lot of these things existed, like native scripts. A lot of stake pool operators like yourself were familiar with and using native scripts, but nobody had built interfaces, right? And made it easy for a large group of people to use it together. So that's how it started. It was a few people who, were all passionate about it and started really researching into what do we need to build in order to enable DAOs on Cardano. And that's ADAO's core mission. It grew quite a bit, and to this day, it's the core mission is to develop open source software that any project, any group, any DAO can use to govern their protocol, project, whatever on a blockchain, on Cardano.
Awesome. So with that, one of your goals you mentioned there is actually to build a front-end application for the average user to interact with the DAO. And with that, will there also be a front-end application for, let's say the creator of the DAO, the original creator, say to, submit proposals or bring more people in?
Right. So a DAO platform has a lot of different users, right? And you're going to have users creating DAOs, and you're going to have a lot of times those same users and others participating in DAOs. So you'll be able to do both. People need to be able to create DAOs in a way that's understandable. Even if people who aren't familiar with reading or writing code, and then have to be able to participate in them easily, view proposals, and not only proposals, but some of these proposals can be code changes. So understand what those changes mean and what will happen if they're executed.
Awesome. Yeah, I personally think that's very important because, you know, when you start a new company and, you know, let's say the company, you know, is a DAO, it's not even a company, it's a decentralized autonomous organization. That's just one extra piece that your team is going to have to learn and focus more resources on when if there is already an open sourced existing DAO platform that you could use, you could spend a lot more time focusing on, you know, what you're good at, what is efficient for your company instead of the DAO aspect. So I definitely see, you know, a lot of value there. You know, how many, you know, team members are in ADAO and like, how did you guys, you know, come together to build this?
Yeah. So ADAO fluctuates because it is a permissionless merit-based system. So started out with about 8 people. And now there's, you know, well over a dozen what we call core contributors who are really in there every day, organizing the meetings, you know, helping draft and edit proposals, and just, you know, I think a few thousand Discord members and active supporters, contributors. So it's grown quite a bit.